The biggest challenge of traveling and staying off-grid is keeping your power banks charged. The Bluetti Charge 1 is something that's going to solve that problem for me. Now, I live in Michigan. Yes, I use solar, but Michigan, you don't always get a lot of sun. This way, I'm able to put this Charge 1 system into my Jeep using the battery and the alternator of the vehicle as I drive to charge my battery banks at 6 times the regular cigarette lighter, 12 volt, 6 times faster. I'm pretty excited about having this. One of the big bonuses of this Charge 1 system is that I can charge all the batteries 6 times faster than a regular 12 volt. So I've got my smaller unit there that stays in the vehicle, but this is the one that I power my trailer with over there. I'm going to walk you through the full install real quick. The app, which I think is probably one of the best features because you can change how much voltage goes in. So I'm going to be able to charge multiple different types of battery systems. All I need to know is what the max voltage that can go in and have the right adapter, which I think is going to be great because I have a system for my trailer that's really large and then one for the vehicle. I can just pull it out of the trailer, go off-roading, charge it up during the day, and then throw it back in or charge a buddy's when they need it charged up. And also, as always, I put the links for the products down below so you can check them out yourself. Now, let's get into the install, how the app works, and then test this thing out. Let's first talk about what comes with it. You got your Charger 1 here, and you're able to put your input and your output on each side and secure them. It comes with a cable. What's great about this is I'm going to be able to hardwire it to my battery, run it through the firewall over there, which I'll show you in a minute, and then run it into my vehicle. Now, coming around the side of my vehicle, I work out of the side right here. I have a cabinet built, so I'm going to mount it in here. I got the AC70 that it's going to be powering, but I've got a couple other Bluettis that I can use as well, but this one is just the perfect size, having it be, you know, over 700 watt hours. That's just perfect for traveling. I've got a fridge in the back that I keep plugged in, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to mount the system to this decking right here. All right, now I wired this through. I'm not going to hook this up. That'll be the last thing I do, but I ran it across with my other power cables that go through the firewall, ran it all the way along inside the Jeep there, and it comes out to here. And what I'm going to do is I'll show you how I hook it all up, but ultimately I'm going to mount it right back here so that it's out of the way, and then I can run cables up to charge it. One thing I want to talk about is the gauge of this wire. You definitely want to use the system that they have. This is excellent cable. It comes with that extra sheath where you run it through everywhere, and of course it has your on-off power right here. So going to the unit, what we're going to do is we have our output, which is going to be the MC4, is going to be plugged there. And what's nice is I can plug another one into there and then charge this while I'm running. But I can also change up the adapter depending on the system, which is pretty cool. So this will have the out, and then the in will be right here with our two heavy duty cables here. All right, I got both sides seated in. As you can see, you have MC4, won't charge there, but with the AC70 comes all these different adapters, and this is the one you're going to want to use because it plugs in there. So ultimately I want to mount this on a little bracket that I make for here, but I kind of like that the on off is right there too, and I can mount it and be able to switch it on off, switch the power, and it's really accessible where it's at because I don't want to have it on running hot power when I'm just daily driving. But this is pretty cool. I like how it's all getting set up in here. This is going to be really, really nice to be able to charge all different power systems. So now I've connected it to the battery. I want to talk about one more thing, alternator. So they do recommend you have a high level amperage alternator. I have the 240. So this one should be perfectly fine. I think a 180 you'd be fine, but I would charge at a lower rate. But I've got the advanced alternator, so I should be perfectly fine being able to charge it at its full rate. All right, now I've had it hooked up for a bit. I've been driving around, and check this out. It's pulling in 257 watts. This will be charged in an hour and a half, which is quite amazing. It's probably running at the full 56 volts. You're able to, 58 volts is what this one is. You're able to look on each system and see the max that it actually has. Now, I put in the app, which I'm just going to show you in a second, where I'm able to put how many volts. This is going full throttle. Now you can put it on more of an eco mode because right now it's got the fan, so it's got like a quiet mode. Let's jump to the app because that is really where all the magic happens. Now when you get this, you're going to want to download the app. You can add all your devices on there. Now I have three of them. I have my AC70, which is this one right here, and then my AC180, which is for my trailer that I have that I charge. So that's gonna be great. I want to be able to pull that out, drive around and charge it. Right now that's at 100%. And then the charger one, let's go to that one first. So right off the bat, you can see that it's pulling from my vehicle, which is on right now, 14.3 volts. Now it does have that protection where if it drops down, it'll stop charging so that it doesn't, you know, draw from your car and you'll be able to take off still. And we got 56 volts going out. Every system says what it can it take in. Now let's go to the actual battery pack, its system here. It's kind of cool. You can see everything from here. You can see everything going out or going in and going out. We're now at 51%. When we started this driving over, I was at like 44%, I think. You can still control, which is cool, you can control the whole thing from here where you can turn your AC, DC on. That's kind of convenient because I've been up in my tent and had the larger battery system and being able to turn it off so that it's not wasting power all night. So I've got my smaller unit there that stays in a vehicle, but this is the one that I power my trailer with over there. You can see that it is taking on power right now. What's great is I can just move it into my vehicle and top it off, and then while I'm off riding around, and then come back and hook it up to my trailer. When I get back to camp, I just take it out and I put it into this power box, plug it all in, and I'm able to power my fridge, my lights, all the different chargers that I have in the trailer system. But I'm able to take that battery out, put it in the front seat, charge it up while I'm driving around. My final thoughts on the Charge One is that it's gonna work perfect for my system. If you're somebody that travels a lot, moves from place to place, you should be using this type of a system to charge up your battery. Because I'm not one that just sits in one place, goes and camps and stays in one place. Even if I set my trailer down somewhere, I'm often going off exploring during the day. Why not use the vehicle power to charge up those batteries? That's the Charge One. Like I said, links are down below so you can check one out yourself.